An important tool to understand and manage credit risk is the credit rating migration matrix. In this table, the financial institution maps the probabilities of credit rating changes in the next period. A rating could improve, stay the same, or deteriorate. Let's take a look at an Excel example. In the matrix, we see three possible ratings A, B, and C. Finally, there is D, which stands for default. We should read the matrix at hand from left to right. However, there are migration matrices that are read from the top to the bottom. This is a matter of convention and does not change the principle. We see that the probability of a client with score A to maintain this score in the next period equals 80%. The probability to move to AB rating equals 15%, and to slide to C is 4%. There is also a 1% probability that a client with an A rating will default in the next period. We understand that the sum of all these options or probabilities is 1 or 100%. We see these sums in the last column. For a client with AB rating, there is a 10% chance of moving to the A status and so on. We can also put these transition probabilities in a diagram. The circles represent the states A, B, C, and D. The arrows show the probabilities to migrate from one state to another or to stay put. Again, all the outgoing arrows should add up to 1 or 100%. We call this diagram a Markov chain after the Russian mathematician Andrej Markov. We notice that clients that end up in the D group, which stands for default, will stay there. There is no way out, and the probability to stay in that state is 100%. The client is captured in that state and cannot escape. Credit migration matrices play an important role in credit risk management. They provide a view of the expected future risk. It is a forecast of what the financial institution expects to happen. Of course, the real results might be different. Still, it makes sense to go through this exercise. It is an excellent tool that helps the financial institution to map the risks ahead. The data for this matrix could come from various sources. Historical data collected by the financial institution itself. Estimates from credit analysts from the financial institution itself. Data shared with other financial institutions working in the same market. Finally, for some markets it is possible to buy these data from a commercial rating agency. Another reason why credit migration matrices are important is the link with the concept of risk-weighted assets, or RWA. Risk-weighted assets is one of the key concepts of the Basel Bank Regulation Accords. The concept is that banks maintain a capital buffer that is linked to the size of the exposure and the credit rating. The better the rating, the lower the capital requirement in percentage points. One of the consequences of the risk-weighted asset approach is that a portfolio that deteriorates in credit quality will require a higher capital buffer. Even though a client respects all his obligations to the financial institutions, a credit rating downgrade will affect the bank through higher capital requirements. We already explained that the transition matrix is for one period or step. For instance, 1 year. We could ask the question, what happens if we go through two steps, so 2 years? To better understand this problem, we focus on just one rating category and see what happens. Let's focus on the clients that have an A rating currently. Our question is, what percentage still has this A rating after 2 years? So, the starting point is A, and the end point is also A. In these 2 years, ratings could follow different paths. An A dossier could start at A, stay A, and end with the A status. Or it could start with an A rating, be downgraded to B, and upgraded to A again. There are four of these paths. Each transition has a probability. For the 2 year interval, there are two transitions. The probabilities for these transitions should be multiplied. So, for the path where a client stays in A, from the start through the first and second year, we need to multiply the probability to stay in A with again the probability to stay in A. This is 80% times 80%, which equals 64%. We repeat the same process for the other paths. We find the probabilities in our migration matrix. the sum of the products for each of the paths yields the combined probability to start with an A rating and end with an A rating in 2 years. This combined probability turns out to equal 65.7%. If we look at the data in the column for the first year and the second year, we notice that these arrays are similar to the first row and the first column of our credit migration matrix. Multiplying these two arrays is bothersome. We need to multiply the cells in the arrays pairwise and to get the products in the following way. Repeating the same calculations for other takes much effort. Excel offers a shortcut which helps us to calculate these combined probabilities in one shot. We will not enter the complexities of matrix multiplication here, but intuitively we understand we need to multiply these tables. Excel's MMULT function, which stands for matrix multiplication, helps us here. To make the calculations easier, we assign a name to the data in the migration matrix. We call these data matrix A. To see the situation in two steps, so 2 years, we need to multiply the matrix by itself. We do the following in Excel, is equal to MMULT matrix A, matrix A. This result is the state of our credit matrix in 2 years. We could apply a similar approach to get a forecast for 3 years. Now we need to nest the functions. Is equal to MMULT, MMULT, matrix A, matrix A, matrix A. We see the resulting matrix here. We notice in general that the ratings deteriorate over time. Once a client has entered default, there is no way back. So, the number of dossiers stuck in this status can only grow. Repeating the matrix multiplication many times will lead to the default of all clients. In the long run, we are all dead. In this video, we explained the concept of a credit migration matrix and its importance for credit risk management. Using matrix multiplication in Excel, we can create a forecast. This forecast helps us to evaluate future risks and steer our capital planning. Good luck, and thank you for watching.